Total Energy's ENP Uganda launches project to skill 200 youth. UMA to boost consumption of locally made phones. Kenya suspends ban imposed on powdered milk imports. Kenyans to pay more for petrol. Plus, East African Community seeks to boost trade under AGOA. So we are running down the month of March and probably, you know, heading up into April. The festive Easter season rather should be coming through. And there's all this excitement about how the year is faring so far. Real quick, and so many things happening. And talking about so many things happening, the East African region and the whole business idea thing of a free market is something that we probably have to look into. So we know for a fact that Kenya recently again, you know, put up a ban against the import of dairy products from Uganda. And this was aimed at protecting the local farmers and the business community in Kenya. I keep talking about protectionism and just how open can the East African region be. We know for a fact that there was that issue of eggs as well. So it's not entirely new that this is happening. For now, it has been lifted. And when the presidents sit and talk about all these things, sometimes it looks more like meetings of the heads of state and not really, you know, something that goes trickles down to the traders. And it's probably something that we need to look deeper into. At what point are we going to have this freedom for the business community, for the farmers, to freely have goods move across the region, as is the case on paper? Plus, still across the East African region, Kenyans have been warned that petrol prices should be shooting high soon. I keep saying this only trickles down to us in Uganda, as we rely more on the port of Mombasa to have our fuel shipped in to the country. My name is Simon. Thank you so much for joining us on the show this week. From wherever you're watching, you are welcome to the Business Show. Let's run you through what's coming up on the show tonight.
E-commerce can be made a big thing, starting with the basic fundamentals, right? The basics are that we need access to the internet, equitable access to the internet for both men and women.
Once again, welcome to the show. And this week, we want to continue that conversation about how digital solutions can create an avenue for different people or Ugandans to have not just financial freedom, but also access money at ease or with ease, plus conveniently. And this week, I'll be speaking to Samuel George Ochaya, who is the head of business at Letsego Uganda. He tells us just how digital channels and financial solutions are delivering services, most of money to the people, plus those seeking to acquire loans, how the different digital platforms make this easy. Of course, one, there is a time factor, convenience is the other, but also generally the risks. So the question I asked was, how do they deal with fraud? Viz from the top.
So traditionally, we've been using our human resource to reach out to our clients to go and do sales through direct sales agents or through relationship officers. But in the time of COVID, we actually looked to see how can we be able to reach these clients as quickly as possible and in the most convenient manner. So we went ahead and developed some platforms that helped us reach out to our clients. The most popular of these, of course, is what we commonly refer to as a digital mall. The digital mall is our mall where customers are able to access services without it necessarily being a physical mall. So you have a lot of the malls around Kampala. You look at it that way, that there's one that is digital. So in there, we have got our products. Our customers, especially the government employees, are able to go and access loans. You can get a loan in less than 10 minutes. And yet, if you went through the traditional way, it could take you maybe 12 to 24 hours to access that facility. So the digital channels that we have developed really make it very convenient for a customer and also handle the turnaround time towards achieving that which you intended to. The idea around offering these solutions via the digital channels is to address a few things on the side of the customer, but also on the side of the provider. So for a customer, it is very convenient. You don't have to meet somebody who could potentially be having a bad day, and then they treat you poorly. So the phone will not complain to you that, you know, I'm not happy today, I didn't sleep well. So the phone will just serve you as long as you have got the data available to apply for the facility. Likewise, you don't have to incur costs of going to a branch, and maybe you might bounce, you may get an accident along the way, God forbid. So the digital channels are very convenient for the customer. But also for us as a player in the market, it is good for us because it helps us operate efficiently. That means less cost to be able to deliver the same service to the client. But that being said, playing in this cyberspace exposes us to potential cyber criminals, and we've invested heavily to ensure that our platforms are secure. We have worked with, we have got very well-trained staff who are in charge of our security. We have got the best kind of software to make sure that our customers and ourselves are not exposed to cyber criminals. And that obviously requires that our people who are in charge of security keep upgrading, because the cyber criminals are also working. As you're working, they're also working to get better. But just to assure our customers and the public out there, security of their information, security of their data, and security of the money is extremely important to us. So, and we've taken care of that. We have not hit the potential that we can, but we are on our way to get there. We really intensified our investments in this digital journey in the time of COVID. That's when we really, really went out of the way to make sure that we are able to service as much of the Uganda population as possible. So we launched the Digital Mall, which is an omni-channel, if I could say. Somebody can access it through the Let's Go app. They can access it on web. They can also access, we are soon launching it on WhatsApp and on USSD. So all those are mechanisms with which anyone across the country where there is a telephone network is able to access services, meaning that wherever the MNOs or the telcos are, we are there as well. So using our USSD code, I think that is *287#. A customer, at the moment we have enabled it for government employees, a customer can actually get a facility in very few minutes. I spoke about 10 minutes prior on the digital mall, but in the USSD it is actually shorter. That it can take you 2 to 3 minutes to get the facility. So having brought it to the simplest and most common application of mobile banking, which is through USSD, we are able to reach a very, very large population in Uganda, over 20 million subscribers that are on the MNOs, on the network. So money, this is now advice to anybody out there who's interested in borrowing. Money, using other people's money, as we call it, is a very good thing. You know, it is, other people's money can help you achieve your dreams faster than it were if you are to use your own money, because you'd require to save for a while. Imagine if you wanted to buy a piece of land and it's 50 million shillings and you're only able to save 500,000 shillings per month. When would you acquire that property? So you can utilize other people's money, so to speak, to achieve your dreams sooner than you had intended. And let's say, because of the area we play in and the expertise which we have developed over time, we find ourselves playing in a space where customers who want to acquire money to achieve their dreams faster come to us, because the red tape on our side is not as thick as it would be in the more established tier 1, 2, 3 financial institutions. So yes, there's convenience on our side. There's a bit more flexibility on our side. We can accommodate a bit more risk than the other institutions would. So yeah, I think Let's Say would be a very good partner for all those who are in the different sectors, whether it's agriculture, education, housing, and consumer borrowing as well. Yeah. We are thankful to the legislature, executive, that introduced the authority that regulates us, that's Uganda Microfinance Regulatory Authority. It brings a lot of sanity within that tier four, and so it creates a certain level of accountability and governance, improvement of governance in that tier. Previously, you were just regulated under, I think, the Company Act, and there was no specific regulation to direct on things like consumer protection and other practices that we think should be prudent for somebody handling finances. So we are very grateful, the regulation. The regulator is getting stronger and stronger as the years go by. So we're very happy. We are working a lot with partners. We are not trying to reinvent the wheel, as we would say. There are so many players within the country that have a large scale of customers. So we are doing a lot of partnerships. In agriculture, we're doing a lot of partnerships in the telecom sector. We're doing a lot of partnerships in education. Players like Opportunity International, which are in the education sector, we're working a lot with companies that collect data and do credit scoring and credit reference bureaus. So that is what we're trying to do, leverage on the strength of others and get a win-win situation. So we believe, and we're quite confident, that in the next 1-2 years, let's say, we'll be a very, very significant player in the financial services. So at the moment, we've got two segments that we work with. The first one is the consumer segment. Those are the people that take salaries. And under our digital mall, we are introducing the financial literacy component. So if you're able to download the app, you'll be able to get some tidbits on how to manage your finances, where to deploy your money when you borrow and things like that. Then the other segment, which is the MSE segment, micro and small enterprises, those are relationship managed segments. Each customer gets a relationship manager. And that relationship manager is the one that is able to guide the customer on how to handle their finances. So we do a check to see, are they able to pay their loans? Are they being monitored properly? And that can only happen if we also invest in our officers to train them. So just this year, we've just concluded a full-scale training on relationship management and credit appraisal for our customers. So we are doing quite a bit customer side, but also internally to be excellent.
So Samuel there tells us about how fraud can be dealt with, and the conversation with him was just, if we talk about convenience, do we guarantee the safety of these people? Because you see, most people will tell you, I still count on the banks because I know where they're located. I can walk in and ask if my money is missing. But look, if we're going to move into the 21st century and off, the thing for you should be, look at convenience, look at time, look at how much you are saving as a business person. It's important to go to a bank. I'm not saying don't go to the bank. It's important to go to the bank to see the person that you think keeps your money. But I tell you what, ask your colleague who probably counts more on online transaction, click on their phone and they have their money within. They will tell you the way they run business is different. I have a friend who will tell you they do not touch cash. All their transactions are done online. And it's probably something that we'll probably think about economy, you know, with time to come. Can only hope that more Ugandans can adopt this and digital platforms be more welcomed by the citizens. All right, you're watching The Business Show with me, Simon. Time now for a quick break on the program. In the meantime, feel free to get in touch with us. Tell us what you think and where you're watching from. Also, drop us a comment on our handles at Tessoctel right below your screen. Stay with us. I'll see you after the break.